fate hasn't come easy, has it?
I've always been a very logical person. If something's broke, I need to be able to touch it, feel it, find out what's wrong with it, and fix it. Right. And that just doesn't work when it comes to faith.
Okay. But yet, you have faith now, right?
Yes.
Okay. So what happened to get from the logical part to here?
I decided to run a marathon, a half marathon. I'm not a runner, never been a runner. What possessed me to try this, I don't know, but I decided to try this half marathon. And no matter how much training I did, I never seemed to be able to make it past the 10-mile mark. So I decided to pray about it and hand it over to God and see, tell Him that I needed His help.
You're praying to God for that help. And you're still training, though. You're still doing the things you need to do physically, and you come up to race day.
Well, everything started out fine. We made it to the 5 miles, 6, 8 miles, and feeling pretty good. I keep going, keep pushing, and I get to the 10-mile mark, and I said, "Hey, here we go. Can I do it or not?" Mm-hmm. And I felt a raindrop on my face, and then another, and another. Before I know it, it's raining pretty good. Conditions are deteriorating quickly. And that's not what I was hoping for.
Now, Kelly, you're the vulnerable wife, so you're there cheering and bawling. So you were out in the crowd in the rain as well?
Yes, I was. I'd come out to watch all the racers come in and felt it start to rain. And I immediately just started praying, "Lord, just please stop the rain. You know, He just doesn't need this today."
But you're still out in the rain running.
Across the 10-mile mark, pushing along. I get to 11 miles. And it's still raining, but I'm feeling all right.
Good.
It's not too bad. I get to the 12-mile mark. I'm thinking, I'm going to make this. I got a mile to go. My knees are feeling pretty good. So then my mind starts again analyzing everything that I've done.
Right.
And what's gotten me to this point. And I start thinking about everything that I ate this week. And got a good night's sleep last night, went to bed early, got up and did some extra stretching this morning.
All this stuff's going through your head.
All through my head. My logical, analytical mind just churning full speed ahead. Got it all figured out, and I'm still forging ahead. And I can see the finish line half a mile in front of me, people cheering. My mind's going a mile a minute, and then it stopped, because I heard something, and it's a song playing on my iPod that I've been listening to for the last 12 and a half miles, 280 possible songs on this iPod, and what's the song that's playing as my mind is spinning 100 miles an hour on what's gotten me here, and the song that's playing is "Casting Crowns."
I get these lyrics for us. Can you read some of those for us?
Yeah. The first verse I heard as I realized the song was playing was, "And it's pouring down rain." We're approaching the finish line. Is, "As the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain. You whisper through the rain. I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I raise my hands, I praise my knees, the God who praise gives, the God who gives and takes away. I will praise you in the storm, and I will lift my hands, and so you are who you are, no matter where. You are who you are, no matter where I am. Every tear I cry, you hold in your hand. You never left my side.
Well, you said your mind was racing before that, and the things you were thinking about, did you just, did this go away, or are you starting to put things together now, or?
Now, I was trying to rationalize and analyze everything that got me to that finish line, and all the logic that I wanted to believe just got washed away and was dissolved in rain that day. It was God,
right?
It was His answering my prayer to help me through those final 3 miles.
In the meantime, you don't know any of this is going on, right?
No.
You're still praying to God.
Stop the rain.
Stop the rain.
I had no idea. I knew he was emotional when he came across the finish line, and I actually cried just because I was so happy for him that he had actually, you know, made it through the race.
Sure.
But it was several days later before he told me.
I still had to analyze it a lot.
Yeah.
And so when he told me that, I was just amazed that God had, you know, here I was standing there praying for it to stop raining, and I could just picture God up there saying, Kelly, I'm in control here. It has to rain today. And, you know, just how he used all these things that I had would never have imagined, you know, a marathon and an iPod and a song and rain,
right?
You know, and brought those things together to answer my prayer that I had been praying for so many years.
The following Sunday.
Okay.
I decided to go forward on Sunday morning and accept Jesus as my personal Savior. And I was baptized that morning.
Right. But that's not the end of the story, okay? You're still having a great time. You're a perfect Christian now, right?
No, I wouldn't say that.
No, okay.
As much as I would like to say that I've got it all figured out and I know how it all works, I know that's not who I am and probably not who I'll ever be. I'll never figure it all out. I'll never know what God has planned for my life. But I know He'll be a part of my life.
You had kind of a little bonus thing happen a couple weeks ago. You got a chance to see Casting Crowns in concert.
Kelly had bought some tickets for us to go see Casting Crowns, and Scott and Jen Clemens were going with us, and they had gotten tickets too. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know when he got his tickets if he was able to get two backstage passes.
Oh, sweet.
And Jen volunteered her backstage pass so that Scott and I could go back and meet the band and tell them my story.